हेलो, वेलकम टू एवरीवन। इन दिस वीडियो दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 30। वी ऑलरेडी कवर 29 लेक्चर टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम, थर्मल फिजिक्स प्रॉब्लम। एक्चुअली दिस इज द 15 पार्ट ऑफ दिस बुक, दैट इज द थर्मल फिजिक्स बाय एबी गुप्ता एंड एचपी रॉय, सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम ऑफ दिस बुक। एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द पार्ट कंसिस्ट अनदर बुक सॉल्यूशन, दैट इज द कार बंसल घोष। सो इफ यू वांट्स टू वॉच द प्रीवियस लेक्चर, यू कैन गो थ्रू डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स, लिंक्स आर गिवेन देयर। And there are different separate playlist for theoretical part of this thermal physics. You can also go through the description box. And in this YouTube channel, Physics by Lakshmikant Sir, you can get different physics related video, mainly problem solution and some theoretical part and some mathematics part also. So if you want to watch these things, you can go through the description box, link are given there. Or in these different playlist are given for this YouTube channel, you can use this link, right? In this video, I want to discuss question number 41 to 51 of chapter 7 of this book, that consists the second law of thermodynamics, entropy, right? So let's start with question number 41, which says that the two identical bodies, each having the thermal capacity at the constant volume Ct, as given like that A by T, are in the initial temperature T10 and T20. This is the temperature of these two things. The two bodies are brought in the thermal equilibrium with the each while delivering maximum work, so that the equilibrium temperature and the maximum work will be like that. So the temperature taken by this body 1 is Qt equal to Ct dT, which is T0 to Tf. If we take the final temperature as Tf, so you will be get this one here. This you can see this the constant volume, that's why this part, that is P dV part, will be 0. So you will be get this one. In the next part, in the next buff, in case of the second body, you will be get this one. You will be take, since heat release, that's why this is Q1 and he is taken out by sink. This is denoted by Q2. This is taken by is released by this released by the body Q body T2. This Q1 equals to like that and Q2 equal to like that. Okay. So the entropy change by body 1 equals to like that, delta S equal to dQ by T. So if you integrate it, you will be get this one. And entropy change for body 2, you will be get this one. And since entropy, total entropy change of the universe will be 0, so these two are equal. From here, you can easily find out the final temperature of this system. And now the work done is nothing but Q1 minus Q2, separate of this Q1, Q2, you obtain this Q1 and Q2. Just difference this Q1 and Q2 and put this value of Tf, which obtained in this one. So if you put these two value in Tf in this expression, you can easily find out this work done, which is the maximum work done, because this entropy, total entropy change of the universe will be 0. So this will be the maximum work done. Go to the next one. Next question says that a system maintain a constant volume, has a heat capacity of constant volume is like that, which is independent on temperature. This is not dependent on temperature. The system is initially at the temperature T1 and heat reservoir at the temperature T0 is available, so that the maximum work done obtained by the system is cooled by this reservoir is given by like that. So W equals to like that. So the work done will be like that. So you know this eta is W by Q1. So W equals to integration eta dQ. So the value of eta, you know, 1 minus T0 by T at up to a certain temperature. When the temperature of sink is T0 and the temperature of the source will be T, so the efficiency will be 1 minus T0 by T at dQ equal to Cv dT. So if you put this value here and if you integrating, you can easily find out this answer. Go to the next question. That cannot solve at this moment. And this is also cannot solve totally, but impartially I can say, consider a system immerse in a medium at the constant temperature T0 and assume that the only reservoir with the system exchange heat the medium. Let the system undergo process involving absorption of heat Q1 and W change. This is the entropy change. You know the entropy change will be like that. So Clausius theorem for reversible is maximum, irreversible is minimum. So in case of dq, du plus dw, and if you put this value in separate out this one, you can easily find out this expression. But this cannot be find at this moment. Okay. Go to the next question. Next question says, a thermally insulated cylinder closed at both end. This is closed into end. This is closed in this to end. Okay. This is closed. Now, says the heat conducting piston, this heat can conduct through this piston, divided the cylinder space into two part. Initially, piston is clamped in the center. So initially, this is in middle position. With 1 liter of air, 300 Kelvin at 2 atmospheric pressure, and another side, 1 liter of air, 300 Kelvin, 1 atmospheric pressure. The piston is released and reach equilibrium in pressure and temperature at new position. Calculate the final pressure and the temperature. So from this relation, PV equals to constant, you will be get the relation in case of this one. This is if you take this as a 1 and this as a 2. If you take this is as a 1 and this is as a 2. So for 1 and 2, you can say that is P1 is 2 and PV1 is 1 and PF and VF. So V1F equals to 2 by PA, right? So for second part in the same manner, you will be get this P2, V2 equal to constant. So if you put this value, you will be get this one, and from there you will be get P1M, that is final volume of this system, which is nothing but the P2F is 2 minus, because this total volume is 2 liter. So the second volume of the second part, that is the second portion, will be 2 minus of volume of first part at the final position. So you will be get the pressure will be 1.5 atmospheric pressure. And the final temperature can be find out this from this relation, which is 300 Kelvin. So since this temperature are the same, so there is no change in temperature, same process. Next question. The entropy of an ideal monoatomic gas is given like that, where U is the internal energy, V is the volume, N is the number of particles, G is statistical weight, M is the mass of the atom. Find T, P, chemical potential of the ideal monoatomic gas. So TdS equal to du plus PdV, and constant volume, so constant volume means dV is 0, so TdS equals to du, so T equal to del u del s at Vn. Okay, so after getting this relation, you know the S equals to like that, which is given. So if you derivative this S with respect to u, you can see here this is constant part, only derivative of these three things. So ln means 1 by this, and derivative of this in m by this one. So after getting this, you will be get 3r by 2u. So the T equals to del u del s at this, so this one will be like that. So T equal to 2u by 3r. So this is the temperature. Next question, find the pressure. Since you know this du equals to 0, if you take du equals to 0, that's mean u equal to constant, you will be get P by T equal to that one. So P equal to like that. So you need to find out del s del v. So if you derivative with respect to v, you will be get this one. This part will be like 1 and this is 0, so you'll be get that one. So P equals to this RT by V, and you will be obtain this T value is like that, 2U by 3R, you will be get P equal to 2U by 3B. Go to the next one. Next one is the chemical potential. The basic definition of the chemical potential is minus T del S del N at the constant U and V, energy and volume. So this is the expression of S. If you derivative with respect to N, the derivative with respect to N is 1 and K into multiply by total things. And after that, the NK and derivative of this with respect to N will be like that, with respect to N will be like that. So after simplifying, you can do this simplification very easy. After simplifying, you can easily find out this expression. Clear? So I think you can do this simplification, no problem. Go to the next one. Next question says, a substance is made to undergo the following cycle of reversible operation. First one, heat at the constant pressure from T1 to T2. So at constant pressure, temperature change from T1 to T2. Expanded adiabatically until the temperature fall to T3. So then expand to after to temperature fall to T3. Cool at the lower constant pressure until temperature is T4. That is cool at constant pressure. And then compress to at reach T1. Obtain the expression of the work done in this cycle. So from this relation, PV equal to RT, you will be get the pressure at the 4 point V1, V2, V3, V4. And you know this is the adiabatic process, and these two is these two are isobaric process, and these two are adiabatic process. For pressure, for process one, this Q1 equal to CV and to temperature, and this is PdV, that is volume change. And you will be get this V equal to V2 equals to RT2 by P1 and V1 equal to RT1 by P1. So P1 is cancelled out, RT2 minus T2. So CB plus R, which is CP, and T2 minus T1. So similarly in process 3, that is T3 through T4, you will be get the heat rejection. Actually this is minus, heat rejection will be like that. But in 2 and 4, this is adiabatic process, so there is no heat change. So the work done is nothing but the heat in minus heat out. Heat in is like that, heat out will be like that. So this will be the work done expression. Now this will be maximum when if you rearranging them in this form. And the symmetry T1 equal to T3, if you take T1 equal to T3, and this will be root under like that. So if you take this T1 equal to T3, you root under this one, you will, this part will be 0, and this will be maximum, because to maximum of this work done will be like that. So the work done, maximum work done is Cp into this one. Clear? Next question. Next question says, 1 mole of monoatomic ideal gas, this is monoatomic ideal gas from state A to B. State A is the TB and the B is the 2TV/2. Quantities of the back rate of the quantities of the TV diagram. The transformation in the two step, the isothermal compression in the point through the C, which is T, V/2, followed by the isochoric part. So you can see that this is the isothermal, this temperature is constant from TV to T, V/2, then isochoric process from T, V/2 equal to 2T, V/2. This is the 2%. So in case of AC, you can see this is temperature is constant. So DT part, that is internal energy part, will be 0. Only the remaining part is PdV. So this will be like that, PdV. So P is nothing but RT/V. You will be get this one, RdV/V. So this is ln V2/V1. And V2 is V/2. So you will be get minus RLn2. In case of CV, dQ equal to CV dT, because this volume is constant, so PdV part will be 0 in this expression. So dQ delta S, that is the entropy change, will be CV dT by T, that is ln T2/T1. And T2 is 2T and T1 is T, so this will be 3/2 R ln 2. CV, because this is CV, you need to change into CV in terms of R. So this is R gamma minus 1, you know gamma equal to 5/2, so this is equal to 2/3, that is 3/2 R ln 2. So this is the entropy change in these two steps. Now the question says, if the system taken from A to B along the straight line path, if you take this along straight line path of TV diagram, what will be the entropy change? So in case of straight line path, the entropy change will be, heat change will be, these two will be changed, pressure, volume and temperature both are changed. So if you you need to take these two part also. So delta S, that is the entropy change, is equal to delta Q/T. So expression of delta Q equal to like that. So if you put this thing, CV dT/T, and this is PdV/T, so P/T dV, if you put this value, P equals to PV equals to RT. So P/T is nothing but R/V. So if you put this value R/V, so this is RdV/V. So RLn V2/V1, and if you integrating, so this is RLn2. And you know CV equals to R gamma minus 2/R. So put this value 3/2 RLn2, and this is minus R. So finally you will get entropy change will be half RLn2. Clear? Next question. Next question says, air is following through a horizontal and insulated duct, and the pressure and the temperature as mentioned at two different points, that is A and B, are PA, PB, TA, and the pressure temperature at this point will be like that. Assuming air to be an ideal gas, so that the change in entropy is given by like that. So the change of entropy, dQ/T, dQ equal to CV dT/T, PdV/T. And you know PdV is nothing but RdT minus VdP. If you separate out these two things, so you will be get the CV plus R, which is CP, and this one. Okay. So if you integrating this thing, you will be get this one, no problem. So if you take this R as a common, you will be get this one. This is the entropy change. Go to the next one. Next question says, a cyclic heat engine operates between two sources, that is temperature T1, which is 800 degrees centigrade, that is 1073 Kelvin, and the same temperature is 30 degrees centigrade, that is 303 Kelvin. Calculate the least rate of heat rejection per kilowatt net output of the heat engine. Output means the work done. The work done is 1 kilowatt. Then what will be the heat rate rejection? That is the heat taken from this. Heat reject to this sink is Q2. You know this diagram, that is the Q1 taken from T1 with the engine which work out, and this temperature is Q2. Sorry, you need to find out this Q2 temperature heat, right? And you know this Q1, Q2 equal to T1 by T2, so Q1 equals to in terms of Q2. And W equal to Q1 minus Q2, so W by T equal to Q1 by T and Q2 by T. If you put this value of Q1, you will be get this one. So Q2 by T, that is the rate, will be like that. And this is nothing but 1. And if you calculate this one, you will be get 0.3935 kilowatt. So this will be the rate of heat which ejected to the sink. You know this is the sink and this is the source. Clear? Go to the next one. Next question says that is the specific heat Cp at a substance varies the temperature will be like that, where A, B, C are constant. So that the change in entropy is like that. So this is the change in entropy you need to see that. So you know change in entropy equal to the integration dq by T and dq nothing but CVdt PdV, and you know the PdV equal to nothing but RdT minus VdP. If you take this RdT equal to CpdT, and this part will be 0 because the pressure will be constant. So you will be get this one, putting this value of Cp in separate out, integrating, you can easily find out this answer. Yeah. So I think clear. If there is any doubt, you must comment in the comment box. This is all about me. This is my contact detail. You can connect with me. It is Telegram channel. This is my online platform. This is my YouTube channel. Details. Go to the channel. We get this different physics related video, some mathematics. Like this session. If you learn something from this session and share this video to your friends, either he or she also get benefit from this video. Subscribe this channel. If you need this channel, those already subscribe. Thanks for subscribing. Press the bell icon to get notification of upcoming video. So take care. We'll meet in the next video as soon as possible. Thank you.